हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे। प्रायेण देवमुनयो सविमुक्तिकामा मौनं चरन्ति विजनेन प्रार्थनेष्ठा नैतान विहाय कृपणा विमुक्षुये नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपासे। प्रायेण देवमुनयो सविमुक्तिकामा मौनं चरन्ति विजनेन प्रार्थनेष्ठा नैतान विहाय कृपणा विमुक्षुये नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपासे। শিশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল টু বেস্টো কৃপা অন সামবডি, টু বেস্টো কৃপা অন সামবডি ইট মিন্স টু চেঞ্জ হিজ মুড, টু চেঞ্জ হিজ মুড আই মিন টু এনগেজ হিম অর হার ইন হরিভজন। শিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল to bestow kippa on somebody, it means to change his heart and to engage him or her in Hari Bhajan. That is called actual kippa. Without that, all other kind of kippa, not permanent, all temporary. It has got no meaning, actually. The sloka I started with, spoken by Srila Prahlad Maharaj to Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Today is the appearance day of Sri Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Actually, today is the appearance day of Sri Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Everybody thinks this way, that Nrisimhadev can erase all problem from our life. If I am put it into problem, I can pray to Nrisimhadev, then Nrisimhadev can help me, I can get out of that problem. This kind of brain, this kind of mood is not good, actually. This kind of mood is not good. Actually, we cannot engage Nrisimhadev in our own seva. Prabhupada speaking, that all material people, they are engaging Nrisimhadev in their own seva. They are doing all rubbish, they are not following their Guru Varga, not at all. They are facing different kind of problem and they go to Nrisimhadev Nrisimhapalli and pay paramanno to Nrisimhadev garland and pay, Prabhu, I give you paramanno and garland, please look this problem. Prabhupada speaking, as if we like to give service to Nrisimhadev. We want to engage Nrisimhadev in our own seva. That is not bhakti. Material people, they are thinking this way. They never follow bhakti. They are facing problem or they put Nrisimha kavach here so that no problem can touch them. So we like to give Nrisimhadev a nice service. We are not going to serve Nrisimhadev. Actually, to serve Nrisimhadev means to do flawless bhajan. If we are already interested to do bhajan, then we can request Nrisimhadev any kind of adverse situation, I mean unwanted situation in my way of my actual bhajan, you please try to save me. Guru Padma Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami used to speak, used to say this way, that Nrisimhadev always protecting their devotees. But those who are not devotees, they are also requesting. Those who are not devotees, they are also requesting. Actually, Nrisimhadev Bhagavan always protecting Prahlad Maharaj and those who are in the line of Prahlad Maharaj. Vishnu Bhakta Bhavet Daivo Asurastot Viparjaya. There are two kind of, you know, human being you can find. Those who are demonic character, they never like to do any bhajan. And those who are actually, they actually having some good idea, good motive, good mood, dev bhav, they like to do bhajan. So these two kind of, you know, category you can find here. So actually, we want to follow Prahlad Maharaj, because many time before I discuss this point, Prahlad Maharaj is, you know, one Mahajan out of 12 Mahajan already. Then Bhagavatam it is. So Prahlad Maharaj is a Mahajan. We must follow Prahlad Maharaj. That doesn't mean we are not going to follow Rupa Goswami or Sanatana. Don't think that way. We are going to follow Prahlad Maharaj basically to get protection from Nishungadev. And already, if I am following Rupa Sanatana, already I am following Prahlad Maharaj, because it is already there. Like in 100 rupees note, there is 10 rupees note already there. One rupees coin is already there. So no problem. So don't think otherwise. Actually, Popa speaking that we must engage ourselves in Krishna bhajan, then we can request Nrisimhadev to protect us, because different kind of barrier problem can be there in our bhajan. That we can do, that's not a problem. Guru Padmani used to say, Jai Gurudev, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Nrisimhadev. If you speak this way, no problem can touch you. But your mood should be okay. Your mood should be okay, positive. If your mood is negative mood, and if you like to show that you are devotee, it's not good actually. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, Hiranyakasipu, you know Hiranyakasipu? Actually, Hiranyakasipu and Hiranyaksha. Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakasipu, twin brother, you know already. They are actually Jai Vijay, eternal parshad in Vaikuntha, eternal parshad of Narayan. They are actually staying in Vaikuntha. By the desire of Narayan, they are coming here in this material world. There, by the desire of Narayan, it is already there, already written there. When Chatusan speaking, we have done wrong. Prabhu speaking, no, you have done according to my desire. I wanted to get this situation. So originally I am there. You are not responsible. So Prabhu wanted to send this Joy Vijay to Parshad here in this material world to play with them, to establish some Siddhanto, to establish some Leela example in front of us. This way, Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakasipu, we get Hiranyakasipu, Joy Vijay, they are coming here in this material world. Hiranyaksha, younger brother, Hiranyakasipu, elder brother, you know already. Hiranyaksha was killed by Varahadev Bhagavan. Hiranyaksha was killed, by Varahadev Bhagavan. So Hiranyakasipu became very angry. He wanted to take revenge. He wanted to take revenge against Vishnu. All pervading God, Supreme Lord, he wanted to take revenge against Vishnu. You see, so foolish. He wanted to take revenge against Vishnu, so he is waiting for the moment when you can get such a chance so that he can fight with Vishnu and kill Vishnu at all. Those who are demonic character, they always like to kill Guru Vaishnava, they always like to kill Supreme Lord, so that no problem can be there in the way of their fanciful attitude. They want to act according to their own will. They are whimsical actually. They want to prove that we are devotee, we are sannyasi. But actually their whimsical attitude can prove that they are not devotee. If they are devotee, 100% they must follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Otherwise, a big problem. You see the situation prevailing all around, you can, yourself you can see. Big problem. So Prabhupada speaking, actually, the Hiranyakasipu is a demon, big demon. Not only demon, he is the king of all demon. Topmost demon. He is the king of all demon. So he wanted to take revenge against Vishnu. So he is waiting. Now, in his life, he got 4 or 5 boys. Prahlad, Sangalhad, and this way, 4 or 5 boys. 4 boys, I think, not 5. So Prahlad, actually, younger boy. Prahlad Maharaj, actually, from heart, he is devotee, always, he took bath. And Hiranyakasipu was very happy that Prahlad, actually, Prahlad, you know, taking bath, is very happy. Prabhupada speaking, Prahlad Maharaj, he was, he came here in this material world as a son of Hiranyakasipu, but actually he is great devotee. Actually, Hiranyakasipu was very happy with Prahlad Maharaj, but later he went against Prahlad Maharaj. Vital Siddhanta here. What Siddhanta? Prabhupada speaking, the Hiranyakasipu was very happy with Prahlad Maharaj up to that point. Up to what point? When Prahlad Maharaj staying there in their house in this kingdom without speaking anything about the Absolute Truth. Be careful. Up to that point, Hiranyakasipu was very happy with Prahlad Maharaj. Up to what point? Till then, when Prahlad Maharaj started speaking all about the Absolute Truth, then Hiranyakasipu went against Prahlad Maharaj. That is the main point. Same situation in this material world you can find. Everywhere, same situation prevails. If you speak about Maya in the name of Harikatha, if you speak about Maya, people become very happy with you. They can give garland, pranami, billions of dollars. But if you speak Harikatha, they cannot. They cannot come to you. So, actually, at the bank of Radhakundo Prabhupada in Chaturmasa time, someday, actually, Kartik brother, Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, and some people, they are running to hear Harikatha from Sahajya. Prabhupada calling, don't go there, come here. But still they are going, because Prabhupada is so hard, so heavy. Who can digest that kind of pure Harikatha? Who can digest that kind of pure Harikatha? Nobody can digest. Everybody can go against me. I can challenge with Bhagavatam. Actually, everybody going against me. Everybody. When I am speaking about their Absolute Truth, when I am speaking about Prabhupada, they never like me. From heart, they can approve me. Original heart, there. They can confess that I am speaking right. But still, Maya is so strong, Maya cannot allow you to do actual Hari Bhajan. So up to that point, Hiranyakasipu were very happy. But after that, Hiranyakasipu become very, very angry with Prahlad Maharaj. Because Prahlad Maharaj started speaking all about that Absolute Truth. Now Hiranyakasipu want to kill him, though he is his son. Big problem. Actually, point is that Hiranyakasipu went to Mandarachalam Parvat. Big Mandarachalam. To do astute finances, to get power. Same thing, Sisi Gauranga Mahaprabhu speaking in Gaur Lila to Suklambar Brahmachari. Suklambar Brahmachari only drinking milk. He wanted to stay inside Rasa Mandir, Rasa Mandir. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, night time doing Ras Sankirtan, so Suklambar wanted to see this Ras. The Prabhu became very angry. What do you think? Those who are demon, asur, they are also doing astuti and finances. Do you think through astuti and finances you can see me, have the chance to see me? What do you think? Asuro top karet, I give up all. Our bhakti, our mode of bhakti, we are doing fanciful. But when we follow Guru Vaishnava in toto, who is following Guru Vaishnava in toto? Who can say? Who is following his Gurudev in toto? Who can speak rightly? Who can speak? Suppose you are sitting in a big chair like Hiranyakasipu. You have money power, manpower, everything. If you like to pass any remark, there are foolish people, they can accept this remark. But those who are actually Pandit, they are Jnani actually, Bhakti, devotee, they cannot accept you. Actually, point is that we don't like to hear any remark from you. We like to hear from a pure devotee. If he passes any kind of remark, that is most important. Because he is not in Maya. Who can speak? Who is Vaishnava? Who is not Vaishnava? Who can pass remark? Who is Vaishnava? Who is not Vaishnava? Those who are in Maya, they cannot pass any remark. But foolish people, they are running that way. He's already in Maya, he's passing. You have no right to pass any. Only pure devotees, they can pass remark. They can speak rightly, exactly. So this way you see, actually, Hiranyakasipu going to Mandarachalam Parvatam, there to do astuti and penances to get power to fight with Vishnu, whom he is worshipping Brahma. He is worshipping Brahma a long time. After that, Brahma was bound to come in front of Hiranyakasipu. What to do? But Brahma cannot see who is doing bhajan for me. He cannot. And after some time, he was, you full of mud. Hiranyakasipu, because in Satyayug, your pran, asu, in Sanskrit is called asu, asu bigate. Now in Kali Yuga, annagata pran. If you don't take rice means, anna means, if you take something and you can protect your body, that is called anya. For a tiger, a flesh is anya. For Gaumata, grass is anya. And for you, chapati, bread, chapati and rice is anya. So anya means dikta. Nobody knows. So actually, without anya, Hiranyakasipu, all flesh, everything gone. Dibba, Sahasra. He is being astute as a big, long time. All flesh and everything gone. In Kali Yuga, if you don't take rice, you can feel weak. You can fall down. One day, 2 days upavas, who can keep power? Huh? Who? Everybody can. So they are sick attitude. We are sick actually, today fasting. Power can come from Harinam, Harikatha, not from bread and chapati. Foolish. So you see, actually, Hiranyakasipu, he loses his nice body, all gone. Only this, bone and marrow. In Satya Yuga, Asu, Pran, life can stay inside marrow, but at present not possible. That time whole body gone, decomposed already. But Brahma cannot see after this, inside mud. Then after that, from Kamandu is taking some water and giving, drenching this water. After that, Hiranyakasipu again coming out of that mud. Then same complexion, nice complexion, very nice body. Actually, Hiranyakasipu, nice looking, very nice, Hiranyakasipu. After that, he is shedding tears. Asur, they are also shedding tears, out of devotion, they are false devotion, actually. Not actual devotion. If there is self-interest, then it is not at all bhakti. If you have any self-interest, then it is not at all bhakti. Foolish people, they don't know. Thousands of people, they are coming from foreign country, here in India, but they actually don't know what is bhajan. They are not getting actual guidance. All of them, they are influenced by somebody. They are influenced. Maybe by Maya, maybe by, in different way. Somehow, they are influenced. If you are out of influence totally, then you can follow a pure Vaishnava, otherwise not. You should be neutral. If you have some prejudicial idea, then you cannot start bhajan. You should be on neutral platform first. Before starting any bhajan, there's a basic thing. Basic thing. You must take yourself on a neutral platform. Now neutral. Then you can go to positive world or negative world. But you are not in neutral. Have some influence in your mind, inside your mind. So this way, actually, Hiranyakasipu wanted to pay dandavat to Brahma and shedding tears. You are coming to me. After that, he is praying. Hey, what you want? Actually, I want to get benediction from you. Yes, I know. But what benediction? Nobody can kill me. I'm Amar. I said, forever. No, it is not possible, actually. I am also not Amar. I am not going to stay. My body is not eternal. I am going to lose my body. So I cannot give this. No, you have to give this. I want this. Any other thing you want, then I can give. No. I want to perpetual life. No, it's not possible. Then Brahma gone. Again he is doing a student. Again coming Brahma. Hey, what you want? I am very disturbed because you are doing bhajan, calling me. When I am coming, you are not taking any benediction. I went to get benediction. No, that without that benediction, I can give all. Anything you want, I can give, but not that. Then you do one thing. What? In your creation, nobody can kill me. Well, bless you. Not in daytime or nighttime, nobody can kill me. Well, nice, I bless you. By any weapon, nobody can kill me. I bless you, no problem. This way, Hiranyakasipu wanted to make fool of Brahma. Brahma is old man. She wanted to make fool of him. Brahma, Parardho. And now it is Parardho, mane first half and second half. This Brahma is this creation, the second half actually. So Brahma is old man. Now with so you see, Hiranyakasipu wanted to make fool of Brahma, his old man. Anyway, in this way, not this way directly, this way I can get the same benefit. So he's actually foolish. Okay, I bless you. You can get it. After that, Hiranyakasipu coming back from Mandara Chalampar. In the meantime, a nice thing happened. You see what happened? Because you know, Asura, those who are demon and those are demigods, they have fighting always in always in fighting. Fighting among Always they are fighting with each other, all the time. Then when Hiranyakasipu going for Asturian penances there, in Mandavacharan Prabhupada, those demigods, they are getting a nice chance, golden chance to fight with them, to get control over his kingdom, everything. So this is a chance, golden chance. And Indra and all full battalion coming and fight with all, you know, with Asura, demons. Asura, they are also fighting, but they are defeated because their king is not there, gone to Mandarachal Parma to do austerity and finances. So what to do? They are crying, now they are defeated. They gone actually flying here and there, because those who are demigods, they are fighting in, you know, they wanted to kill them. They, to save their own life, they are flying here and there. But somehow, Kwayadhu Mataji was caught by Indra. That's a big problem. Mataji crying, leave me, no. I can take you, please leave me. My husband gone, you are actually demigod, you should not touch me. No, I can take you away. Then she is crying. In the meantime, Narad Maharaji coming. Hey Indra, what you are doing? You should not do. Huh? You are catching a, you know, wife of Hiranya. You should not do. You are actually king. Demigod, you are king of heaven. No, actually I like to kill the son inside his, you know, womb. Inside her womb. Then I can let her free. Not now. You leave. Because one nice devotee going to take birth from his womb, from her womb, from her womb. It's very nice devotee. Oh, really so? Yes. It's big devotee. You have no right to touch him. Leave him. Then Indra Maharaj gone because he is paying respect to Naraji. Everybody respect Naraji. So Naraji is speaking, hey, leave him. Leave her. Then Indra Maharaj gone. Now Naraji Maharaj speaking in front of Kwayadhu, Mata. Mataji, you like to stay with me? Yes. You like to stay with me in my ashram? I can speak Harikatha, you can hear. You are fearless at present. Nobody can put you in problem. Actually, those who are sadhu, how you can feel he is sadhu? One big siddhanta here. How you can understand? How you can understand that Srila Prabhupada is sadhu? How you can understand that Srila Bhaktipurna Turi Goswami Maharaj is sadhu? How you can understand Srila Pagran Bhaktipurna Kesava Goswami Maharaj? How? How to understand? How to realize? Big siddhanta here. In front of that sadhu, if you reach, if you find comfortable, if you find all problem gone, as if all problem gone, darshane pavitra gora itamar gun, at the same time, you can feel free of any problem. You can feel fearless. Because a sadhu, big sadhu always bless you, always like to make you fearless. In Archan Paddhati, you know, you are doing Archan. In Parchan Paddhati, some different mantra is there. Siman Navadipe Dinattam Divijam Gurum Barabhayapadam Swantam Smareta Tannam Purvakam. This mantra is there. Also another mantra, you no one know. You have to do actual Sadhu Sangha. If you do both Sadhu Sangha and Asadhu Sangha, then I am not responsible. Billions of years you can go on hearing Harikatha, but you cannot get result. You will have to do actual Sadhu Sangha. So Deva Bhutta Deva Marchayat. First you will have to elevate yourself up to that level of demigods. Then and only then you cannot see the demigods. As what to speak about that Supreme Lord. And what level you will have to take yourself. You cannot think. So big issue is. And one sadhu, always anybody coming in front of that sadhu, always make him fearless. Barabhaya padam swantam smareta tannam purvakam. Barabhaya padam means this mudra. This mudra means, I bless you. I like to make you fearless. If you feel all problem gone, if you feel full satisfaction, no dissatisfaction, then be sure that he is actual soul. Otherwise not. So this way, actually, in front of Naradji, Kayadu Mataji, she is feeling comfortable. Oh, I like, you can protect me, Sadhu. Naradji, you can protect me. Well, I can protect you. So I like to get blessing from you. What kind of blessing? What kind of blessing? I like to get that kind of blessing so that I can get my issue when my husband come back. Up to that point, I like to stop my issue. I don't like to get my children, I mean, baby out. Okay, I bless you. Then Naradji bless her. You go on hearing Harikatha, no problem, I am there. No problem can touch you. So first of all, Naradji make her fearless. After that, go on hearing Bhagavad Katha, Bhagavad Tattva Vijnanam, Mukta Sangasya Prajayat. Mukta Sangha, those who are big sadhu, only with their association, you can hear Harikatha. Sadhu Sangha Krishna Nam Harikatha also, ehi matto chai, sangsar jinite ar kono bastu nai. You can get victory over this material sangsar, but that is not a big issue. After that, what you want to get? People think to get victory over this material, to get victory over this material world is a big issue. Not that. It's very preliminary. Kindergarten teaching. Kindergarten. Basic thing. After that, what you want to do? Suppose you are out of Maya. Material, these are Sata Raja Tama. Suppose Sata Raja Tama not going to put any influence on you anymore. Okay. Then what you like to do? Now I am successful. No! You are not successful. People think, now I am out of Maya, now am I out of the influence of three modes of nature, so I am successful. Not! You are not successful. Only basic thing you are getting. So now you have to take decision what you like to do. You are out of Maya. Now you have the chance, actual chance. Now you have the actual chance to do Hari Bhajan. Follow my point. When you can take you up to that level, you can take me by the bless of Guru Vishnava, not out of our in. Out of our own effort, you cannot go out of Maya. Out of your own effort, you cannot come out of Maya. Then how? Rajastamascha satyena satyancha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhakta puruso hi anjasa jayat. This is in Krishna speaking in front of Uddhav. By pure Guru Vaishnav Seva, you can conquer this Maya, otherwise not. And if you are doing actual Guru Vaishnav Seva, automatically you are getting bhakti, interrelated. And out of your personal effort, you cannot go out of Maya. Because suppose you are going up out of Maya at present, out of the influence of three modes, still you can fall down. Without bhakti, your heart cannot get saturation. Follow? Suppose one yogi is doing, he is out of Maya. But he is less interested to do direct service to Krishna. Then, that's why Brahma is speaking. Arujya krichena param padam tataha patati adha anadrita jusmat angrayo. Brahma speaking in Dasam Skanda, 10th canto, you can find. Hey Prabhu, those who are ignoring, violating, they want to ignore the seva mood, they are in less interest about the seva of your lotus feet. They cannot come out successful. Again, they can fall. For the time being, they are up. Arujya krichena param padam tataha patati adha anadrita jusmat angrayo. then you can fall down. So automatically, if you are serving pure Guru Vaishnava, automatically by his influence you are going to get, say, bhakti. Bhakti? How you can get? From a devotee you can get bhakti. Bhakti you can get from a devotee who is having bhakti. Is one kind of contagious disease. If you have bhakti, Baba, then automatically you are serving that sadhu, you can get bhakti. Not directly. So you see, now Naraji Maharaj speaking Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan in front of Kayadhu for a long time. But Kayadhu actually, Mataji, those who are Mataji, it is written in Bhagavatam, they are, most of them, they are actually freckle-minded. No stability there, in Bhagavatam there. So their mind is freckle most often. And that's why she is hearing Bhagavat Katha, Hari Katha from Naraji. But she is thinking about husband, about the son going to, she going to, you know, give birth, she wanted to give birth, a baby, or about she is thinking about husband, a situation created by demigod. This is not hearing Harikatha with full concentration, not that. Mind is flying here and there. So automatically his hearing is not perfect hearing. But one benefit, very, very nice result we can get, because that Prahlad Maharaj was there inside the body of Mataji, who? Kayadhu, inside room. So actually, by the grace of Naraji Maharaj, that baby inside the womb of mother hearing Harikatha. Actually, the teacher, guru of Prahlad Maharaj is actually Naraji. A teacher, who is guru? Who is guru of Prahlad Maharaj? Actually, Naraji. By the bless of Naraji, he is hearing all Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan inside. Because now, inside the belly of Mataji, he is in meditation. All baby. While staying inside the baby of Mataji, they are in meditation. Oh, Prabhu, relieve me, relieve me. After that, if I take bath, I can do your bhajan, I promise you. But after that, taking bath, no bhajan. Who is going to do bhajan? Foolish. They want to make fool of Supreme Lord. Oh, Prabhu, garbhastuti. Not all jivatma, actually. Some lucky jivatma. Actually, inside baby, they are getting so much punishment, heavy punishment. Heavy, heavy punishment. It's like hell. But actually, Naraji Maharaj, by the bless of, actually, Prahlad Maharaj, by the bless of Naraji Maharaj, hearing Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan and digest by the mercy of Gurudev. You can attain Harikatha, thousands of Harikatha. But you cannot digest the Harikatha until and unless your Gurudev bless you 100%. Digesting power, you cannot get. You can hear Harikatha, you can run here, there. But if your Gurudev is not Sadguru, if your Gurudev is not Sadguru, or maybe your Gurudev is Sadguru, you are not 100% sincere, or you are not enjoying full kippa from Gurudev, then you cannot digest Harikatha 100%. Preliminary you can hear, you cannot digest. By the mercy of Gurudev, you can digest Harikatha. Digesting power you can develop by the mercy of your Sadguru. Not. Otherwise not. Big problem. So by the mercy of Naraji Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj hearing Harikatha inside the womb of Mataji. After hearing Harikatha. Then after that, when Hiranyakasipu coming back from Mandarachalam, then Naraji Maharaj arranged Kayadhu to reach his kingdom, actually. After that, Hiranyakasipu coming, After that he is, you know, taking control over his own reign. I mean, he is acting as king again. Because after that, Hiranyakashipu is coming. And after that, he is taking revenge against the demigods. He is most powerful. And now he also again take control over his own kingdom. He is most powerful. Because he is getting full mercy from Brahma and coming from benediction. It's very powerful, vigorous energy. Enjoy. Now, demigods, they are fearful. Demigods, they are very fearful. They cannot approach Hiranyakashipu, so powerful Hiranyakashipu. After that, actually, Hiranyakashipu took decision. In the meantime, that baby come out of the womb of mother. Quiet to give birth. To a baby, nice baby. Is actually, his name was Prahlad Maharaj. So Prahlad Maharaj not taking birth, and the Hiranyaka very happy, kissing, taking lap, you know, in cradle sometime putting. This way, full care, Hiranyakashipu. This is very nice boy. After some time, in adolescent age, Hiranyakashipu took decision, I must send this boy for proper education. I must arrange. Hiranyakashipu wanted to send Prahlad Maharaj to the school, into a school of whom? Shukracharya. Actually, Shukracharya main teacher, and now Shukracharya is not present there. So, Sandhya Amarka, two teacher. So, actually, Gurudev gone to some place, Guru Putra, Putra Dvayam, Sandhya Amarka. They are actually teaching as present. So, actually, those who are demon, what is the subject matter of their education teaching? They actually social education, economical education they are giving. It's most important. Because those who are demigods, they want to gain arthokam, not mokho. Dharma, what is dharma? They actually artho and kam. Economical factor, how to get money, how to increase appliances, this is the mode of education. So, Hiranyakashipu sending Prahlad Maharaj to a nice school. Sandhya and Amarka giving education on this point. Political science, economical science is a nice education. But Prahlad Maharaj, he what to do? Because father Hiranyakashipu sending, and they are actually guru. In all full or sweet destiny, actually Shukracharya is guru. So Sandhya and Amarka, his son, two sons, they are bound to obey. So Prahlad Maharaj hearing everything, what Sandhya and Amarka speaking, but from heart he cannot accept. This teaching is not perfect teaching actually. Because Prahlad Maharaj already hearing Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan from Naradji. So when he is hearing all Ravi's education, so naturally he is less interested to hear all this thing. But what to do? He cannot violate. Is the instruction of father, and is the instruction of two, Sandhya and Amarka, Guru Dvay. He is bound to hear. He is hearing everything. But he cannot accept from heart. He is hearing everything. He is not going to insult Guru Dvayam. But he cannot accept. After that, actually, Sandhya and Amarka, they wanted to take decision. For a long time we are giving education to Prahlad. Now it's good if I can take Prahlad in front of Hiranyakashipu, the king. So maybe he can become very happy with us. He can give some big prize. Because we are giving education so nicely. So we can take. So you see, when Prahlad Maharaj actually was taken in front of father, then actually father taking lap. Then I can speak so important points. I can speak because every time I'm speaking. So now we like to recite. You can also feel so nice from Bhagavatam directly. Every year I am speaking without, you know. That's this year I like to recite so that you can also enjoy. So Hiranyakasipu taking lap, and actually. Actually, what happens? Actually, Prahlad Maharaj was sent in front of father. Here it is written in fifth canto. Say Narada Vacha. He was taking in front of Gurudev no sadhu mene. Actually, I told you. Those guru is speaking so many things in front of Prahlad. But Prahlad Maharaj is less interested. He don't feel comfortable. Because he already hearing Bhagavad Katha from Gurudev. So it is written that Yattatra guruna praktyam susrube onupapathacha nasad manasamene sopara sadgruhasrayam. One day, Ekoda sa Asura Rata Putram Ankam Arapya Pandava Prapacha Katatam Batsa Mannati Sadhu Jad Bhavan. Actually, it is written that one day, actually, he was taken in front of father. So, Ekoda, one day, Asura Rata means? Asuraj king, putram ankam arapyo, putting in lap. Pandav, hey Pandav mean? Actually, originally, this Bhagavat Pakha, Sukhdev Goswami speaking, and Parikshit Maharaj hearing. So this way, Pandava, you can go and where is Pandav? Pandava mean? From Pandav family. From Pandav family, this Pandav family, actually, who is Parikshit Maharaj? So that's why it is written Pandava. Pandava means you are in this destiny. That is Yadav. Krishna is Yadav because he is in Jodhu destiny. This way, Ekoda Asura Rata Putram Ankam Arapyo Pandava Prapacha Katatam Batsa Mannates Sadhu Jad Bhavan. Bhavan means what you think fit. What kind of education you are taking from Gurukul, you must speak. If Hiranyakasipu going to put one special question in front of Prahlad Maharaj is a very small boy. He can feel fear. So, Hiranyakasipu going to put one free question so that he don't feel nervous. What do you feel good? What kind of education you take from your Gurukul, please speak in front of me. This way, Prahlad Maharaj, sitting in the lap and speaking, Tat sad manneha asura varja dehinam sada samad vigna grahama sad graha hitvatva padam gihamanda kupam banangata hayad harima asrayet. What speaking? Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Asur, Gurudev. Father, and hey Guru, hey, you know, Asura, to sad manne, hey Asura Varjo, dehi naam. Not speaking father. Prahlad Maharaj not speaking father. Because Prahlad Maharaj is Mahabhagavat. He don't care about this material relationship. Who is father? Who is mother? Tameva mata chapita tameva. Eh? Supreme Lord, he is father, mother. So be careful, ya Siddhanta. Prahlad Maharaj should speak this way, oh my father. Not speaking. Prahlad Maharaj, how Prahlad Maharaj speaking? Tatsad manneh asura varja dehi naam. This way, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, oh, very secret Siddhanta. Those who are actual devotee, they should not think about their material relation with father, mother, this. They never think that way. Prabhupada never speak that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. You cannot show anywhere. In speech or writing, anywhere you cannot see. Even a single instant you cannot show. That where Prahlad Maharaj, actually Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. And you cannot show that Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that Vimala Prasad is my son. Never speaking that. Never. Thus, those who are devotee, they don't care for material relation. So one single Siddhanta. Another Siddhanta is there. The when Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Tat sadhu mannehi asura varja dehi naam, it means Prahlad Maharaj speaking on fault of sadhu. In front of our devotee, he is topmost asura. He is topmost asura varjo. Varjo means topmost. I mean those who are asur. Thousands of asur there, billions of asur there. But you are topmost, you are so notorious, you see. So this way, he is singing, oh, sir, nice honor given by my son. Hiranyaka says, yeah, yes, so nice honor given by... Because you see, different demigods, they... If you offer flower, then Sanidev is Aparajita, you know. And if you offer China rose, red China rose to Kali, become very happy. So this way, Jedevata in demigods, they like different kind of flowers, you see. If you offer, they become very happy. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking nicely to keep balance. He is very shrewd. Prahlad Maharaj is so clever, he is keeping balance. At the same time, Prahlad Maharaj unveiling top secret Siddhanta in front of all devotees, that he is topmost asura, notorious, you know, topmost notorious, Rajatama Gun, topmost. And Hiranyaka thinks, oh, so nice honor he is giving to me. Tatsadhu mannehi asura varja dehi naam, sada samudvigna dhiya masad grahat, hitvatta patham, grihamanda kupam, banam gata haya harimasrayat. Hiranyaka will become very unhappy by speaking. He is speaking about Haribhakti. How possible? Because you see, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, ho asura varja, I think it very nice, very, very fit. That if those material people, they going out of this material sansar, and they can go to forest and take shelter of Hari, I think it is their best solution for them. What? He's speaking about Hari Bhajan? How he learning? Because I sent Prahlad in school, nice school. Huh? But how, where from is he learning this kind of, you know, Hari Bhakti topic of Hari Bhakti? It's not good. At the same time, you see, all people here in this material world, they are always feeling some sort of problem, you see. Only you can see one pure devotee, there is no tension. There is no tension. Always is happy. Why? No headache. If you have your head, then question of headache coming. If you have no head, then no question of any headache. Matha thakli, matha vata. If you have no head, no headache. Shukdev Goswami, very happy. Naradji, very happy. Everybody, happy. When you want to get control over this material world, that is a big bondage for you. Then you can feel problem and tension. You see, why people feeling tension? Because bhakti is amrita. Bhakti is nectar.
So if you are actually getting bhakti, no question of any tension. Why you are feeling tension? Because you are not getting bhakti, amrita, nectar, not getting. You want to get control over this material world. You want to get pratishtha. That's why tension eating you up like insect. If you are if you don't care about what pratishtha you are getting, you don't care about what money or pratishtha, woman, nothing, kamini kanchan pratishtha, then no kind of tension can come in your life. If somebody like to criticize me heavily, repeatedly I told you in front of Bhagavatam, I become very happy. Yes, you can do yourself. If somebody criticizes me, I become very happy, because nobody can disturb me anymore. I like to preach this way, very solid way. My preaching, by the grace of Gurudev and Prabhupada, by the blessings of Guru Bhargava, very slow but steady. Far-reaching consequence you can feel, far-reaching effect inside your heart. Not that after my death also you can feel that Harikatha. So I don't, quantity and quality cannot persist together. I want quality, don't quantity. I am less interested about. So you see, all people here in this material world, they are feeling some kind of tension. Some or other kind of tension is always there. They are not out of tension because some demand is there. So you are showing devotion, but not pure devotion. Pure devotion means without any kamana vasana. Akama sarva kama va moksha kama udarati tibrena bhakti yogena jajito purusham param. What kind of advice you are getting? Akama sarva kama va moksha kama udarati. If you have different kind of desire inside your heart, if you have no kind of desire, nothing, still you have to do Hari Bhajan. Akamo sarva kamo va moksha kam. Moksha kam means you want to get free of this material world. Moksha. But moksha, this word, if I like to explain this word according to Gaudiya Siddhanta, then you must hear me, that moksha according to material people, those who are yogi, gyani, material people, moksha mean to go out of the influence of this material nature. I am moksha. I am out of any problem. But as a Gaudiya Siddhanta, sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Moksha mean mukti. Sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Sarup mean jive sarupa Krishna Nitya Das. You are actually eternal servant, made servant, I would say appropriately, because jivatma is you can use it. Yeah. You can speak this way. Follow my point. What does it mean to say jivatma always not actually? So you can. So you are eternal servant of Krishna as Sarup, your Sarup. So if you are established in the Sarup, then and only then you are getting actual moksha, mukti. Muktir hitva anatha rupam. Jiva Goswami was speaking, muktir hitva anatha rupam, sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Any other kind of desire and, you know, where, if you leave everything, if you can get this kind of, you know, platform, when you can discover that you are eternal servant of Krishna, then and only then, Gauriya, they can confess that now you are mukta, moksha. So, sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Mukti hitva anatha rupam, Sarupana Bhavasthiti Itta Mukti. Now, point is that those who are demigods, those who are demons, they always try to get favorable education. What kind of favorable education? They want to get some economical ideas so that my, we can increase the place of money. You know, Kamini Kanchan, these two things they want. Those who are demon, or maybe they are demon in the guise of devotee still. Because Prabhupada speaking this way, we are less interested about opulence, money and, you know, Kamini Kanchan. But too much money, too much opulence we don't need. Prabhupada speaking. Repeatedly, we are less interested about too much money. Because in that case, you cannot have the chance to engage that money for Krishna Seva. That money can kill you. Too much, billions of dollars. But you have no chance to engage. Nobody there. Everybody like to kill you for that money. And then you can insult Guru Vaishnava. It is written there. Because Srimad is topmost. Janmai sajjo sruto sibi redhamana manah madah pumano naiva arhati avidatam vaitam kinchana gocharna. Kunti Devi speaking. You can have false ego, you can get puffed up. Four different kind of factors are their basic factor. If you are taking birth in a high family, if you have big appliances, if you have educational power is there, if you are good looking, very nice looking, handsome or very beautiful, then you can develop apradh, 100%. Out of those four, Kamini Kanchan is topmost. It's topmost, topmost factor. Because if Kamini Kanchan is there, you are 100% going to fall down. 100%. Because then you can think, I am a big educated man, I have so much education. Automatically, if money is there, if you are from a low caste family, still you can think, I have money, I am Hiranyakashipu. Huh? Those Muslim people, we never want to insult them. It is in Chaitanya Bhagavad written, Haridas is doing Harinam. So he can meet with, after that he can meet with very bad consequence. Parinam Kharap, Muslim people speaking. Better we can beat him and throw in Ganga. He can get Asadgati. Asadgati, you see? So Muslim people think this way. Demon also think this way. They think if we are doing Hari Bhajan, this is very bad. So if you have money power and manpower, automatically all other factors bound to come, take entry inside your heart. Suppose you have actually Kamini Kanchan. All other ego is not there. But still, all other ego can come automatically, without invitation. Because money is there, too much money, affluence. You can insert, you have the chance to insert Guru Vaishnava. Uses no money, nothing. 100% you can do and can fall down. A Siddhanta there. So Prabhupada speaking, we are less interested about too much money and offences because it's not necessary for in our life. Prabhupada speaking, it is not necessary in our life. Otherwise we can become interested to insult Guru Vaishnava, ignore Guru Vaishnava. Prabhupada speaking this way. So this way you see, actually Hiranyakashipu giving education about economical education and dharma, not dharma, only dharma, artha, kam, moksha. Dharma, artha and kam. Artha and kam, not even moksha. Dharma, asura, they are doing dharma. Yeah, yes, they are also sometimes doing dharma. But they don't do, like, you know, they actually who? Jarasandha. He is doing jagya every day. Without jagya, not taking water. When Krishna coming, he is actually beating. He is doing sacrifice, fast sacrifice every day. I mean, giving donation to Brahman. But when Krishna coming, he has to, you know, kill Krishna. This kind of, you know, you see? Asura, there is Rakshas and Asur, they can show devotion, but this negative way. So, actually, sometimes they are showing dharma, but that dharma we never, you know, approve that kind of dharma. So, better we can speak this way. Asura, they are interested about artha and kama. It is also very important on those days in Satyayuga, they maintain some rules and regulation about how to enjoy kama. Follow my point, buddy. In Satyayuga, at that time, they also used to maintain some different kind of rules and regulation, very strict regulation about how to enjoy kama. At present, we are going down and down. We have no regulation. Follow my point. In Satyayuga, those Asura, they are also enjoying kama and artha, but also they have some restriction, regulation. At present, we are so fallen soul, that we have no regulation over these two factors, moksha, kama and artha. We are going out of, you know, any control. We are so fallen soul. So that time actually, Prahlad Maharaj wanted to prove this point in front of Asura Raj. Who Asura Raj? Hiranyakasipu. That those people in this material world, they are actually getting so much, you know, anxiety actually. Always tension they are feeling. See, it is good if they go out of this material, you know, material samsara. If they can take shelter onto the lotus feet of, if they can take shelter onto the lotus feet of Hari, then they can feel very nice. Tat sadh manne asur varja dehinam sada samud vigna dhiyam sadgruha hitva tupatam griham andakupam manam gatah yad harimasrayet. If they go inside forest, leaving this material world, then they can feel very nice without, and they can do Hari Bhajan. Now another point is very vital point here, that actually tatsadamande esroje dehinam sadasamudvi asad gruha hitat grihamand kupam. Here Prahlad Maharaj is a Mahajan, one Mahajan, out of 12 Mahajan. Why he is giving advice to go inside forest? Prahlad, we are getting advice from Prahlad Maharaj to enter into forest. So, Prabhupada never speaking this way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, no. No man, come on, you understand wrong way. You understand wrong way. Actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving instruction to Uddhav. Hey Uddhav, actually, Banmin, Banantu Sattikam Bhasam. Banbas? Prahlad Maharaj giving advice, you must enter into forest. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to us, the Banmin, Banantu Sattikam Bhasam. And in logic, Nyay Shastra, you know, Nyay? Nyay means logic. Nyay Shastra. Is Navadvipa's topmost place of Nyay. According to Nyay Shastra, it is written, Purvapekha Paravidhi Balavan. If some instruction is there, preliminary instruction, after that Gurudev or Vaishnav or in scripture, if I find more new instruction, then it is more important than previous one. Follow my point. Don't follow. What to say? You are so Purvapekha Paravidhi Balavan means if you are getting instruction from Prahlad Maharaj, Now you are getting instruction from Bhaktivinoda Thakur, so we must give importance to, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur more filtered way towards Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, more filtered way, so I can accept this. Follow my point. So purvapekha paravidhi balavan. So previous argument I give in scripture, it is written, if I speak some, giving some instruction previous, then after that, if I give, after final instruction, that is more important. Like I can give example in Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving in some Vishad joke. After that, Bhagavan Sri Krishna go on speaking, Sankho joke, Rajguho joke, speaking so many things. After that, Bhakti joke. Then Arjun became puzzled. You should speak one advice. I cannot understand. Tadekam vada nishchitam. You are advising so many things. I am confused. Now you are speaking this one, after they speaking you must follow this one, after they speaking the... Now you are speaking Bhakti Yoga, you are the topmost. Then whom to follow, how to follow? Whom to follow, how to follow? Bhakti Yoga is final outcome. In Gita, Bhakti Yoga is final outcome, 12 canto. 12. Bhakti Yoga. Final outcome. After that, nothing. After that, Krishna giving different kind of idea, but actually up to Bhakti Yoga is final. Final Bhakti Yoga, up to Bhakti Yoga, Krishna speaking. Why? Because there are so many people there, who can know who is in what platform? Suppose that people, he is on karma mark, so Krishna speaking karma yoga. Suppose you are in gyan mark, so Krishna speaking gyan yoga. So this way, for different kind of people, Krishna giving open advice. This, if you are on this platform, you can follow this. If you are on this platform, you can follow this. If you are, but finally, I should speak this way, that Bhakti Yoga is final outcome. All yogi, gyani, everybody, karma yogi, they will have to come. They will have to come. Today or tomorrow, maybe next life, after life, finally they will come this way. To get total satisfaction, total saturation of heart. Follow my point. That's why he's speaking. Final outcome is, Bhakti Yoga is final. Even in Bhakti, different kind of Bhakti is there. So, you will have to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, to get more accurate instruction about Bhakti. Find way. What Rupa Goswami Pada Sanatana giving, from Jiva Goswami Pada giving, we are getting the instruction from Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, more and more nice way, filtered way. More cream we are getting. Now Bhagavan Singh is not speaking.
Banam tu sattikam basam rajasam grama uchate tvamasam duta sadhanam manniketanastu nirgunam.
What Bhagavan Singh is now giving instruction to Uddhav, banam tu sattikam basam rajasam grama uchate. And those who are gambling, you are gambling. That is actually tama. Man nikatanastu nirganam. Those are gambling. Well, you know, they are doing jua. That is called tama mutu. Actually. So it is written that actually banantu sattikam basam rajasam gramochati. And I forget. And man nikatanastu nirganam. Man nikatanastu nirganam. And my place is nirgun, out of the influence of these three modes of nature. So this way, actually, when Poladma is speaking, banam gata hayat harimasrayat, it doesn't mean we'll have to go to forest.
we can stay with nice devotee, pure devotee, and have the chance to hear Harikatha continuously. That is called Nirjan Bhajan. That is called solitary Bhajan. That is called to go inside forest. When we are going to stay with pure Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava, and hearing Harikatha, then actually we are in forest. Forest means no material influence is there. Follow what I say. So this way, actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Banam Gata Yadya Harima Srayed means to stay with Guru Vaishnava and hear Harikatha, do Harikirtan and hear Harikatha. With Harikatan, Harikatan, you have to stay with Guru Vaishnava. Then actually you are in Nirjan, solitary bhajan. Otherwise not. Now actually, Narad ji uvacha. After hearing from Prahlad Maharaj, Hiranyakashipu become very angry. Say Narad vacha.
Srutya putra giro daityo parapaksho samahitah jahas buddhir balanam vidyate parabuddhibhi. Srutya putra giro daitya parapaksha samahitah jahaso buddhir balanam vidyate parabuddhibhi. Srutya putra giro.
When Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way, the Hiranyakashipu will happen, ha 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 ha. Hiranyakashipu laughing. Why? Because Hiranyakashipu was speaking that actually those who are child, they are actually ignorant. If they are hearing something unusual, they can hear this thing and speaking this. So I never mind. Jahaso buddhir balanam vidyate parabuddhibhi. If somebody, they are influenced by somebody because they are child. So Hiranyakashipu was laughing. After the speaking in front of, you know, Samyak Vedharyatam Balo Guru Grehe Diyati Vihi Vishnu Pakkhai Pratichanair Na Vidyatasadhiryatha. Actually, Hiranyakashipu cannot expect this kind of teaching. This kind of education cannot come because Hiranyakashipu cannot respect. Because Hiranyakashipu sending Prahlad Maharaj in the house of Guru Griha, Sanda Namarko. How he is learning this way? Then he is giving instruction to Guru Dwaya, two teachers, Guru. Hey, try to protect my son right way. So that he cannot speak all rubbish in front of me. Be careful. Hiranyakashipu became very angry. Hey, you are not protecting. Where from he is getting this kind of education? There is no chance. They are inside your school. Where from he is teaching? Giving lesson.
Samyak Vedharyatam.
Try to protect my son. So that in future he is not growing this kind of education. Where from he is getting? I send my son to you. You are not protecting?
Samyag Vedharyatam Balo Guru Grihe Diyati Vihi Vishnu Pakkhai Pratichannair Na Vidyatasya Dhiryatha.
So that his brain cannot touch Vishnu. Be careful. After that, he gone. Actually now, those teacher, they taking Prahlad Maharaj again back to school and the house, Guru Griha. Then very secretly asking in front of Prahlad, I am asking one question, we are going to ask one question to you. What? Where from you develop this kind of education? We never speak this way. Please speak right way, don't speak lie. They bring Prahlad Maharaj back in their school, I mean home, Guru Griha, and ask him very secretly, you will have to speak one give answer to this question. Where from you get this kind of education?
Vatsa Prahlad? Vatsa Prahlad? Vatsa Prahlad? Bhadram te satyam kathayo mamrsha.
Don't try to speak lie. Be careful.
Bala noti kutostubhyom esho buddhi viparjayo.
You are actually boy. Where from you get the? We never teach you this way. But where from you get this kind of education? Education. Buddhi vedaha parakrito uto ho te so abhavat. Bhanyatam sattu kamanam guru nam kulanandana. You are kulanandan. We are very proud of you because you are prince, Rajputra. But please speak right way. Where from you get there? Because you see, buddhi veda parakrita, you yourself get this this kind of brain, or somebody teach you. From where you get? What is the source? We like to know. Buddhi veda parakrita utaho te so bhaja so to abhavat. Yourself automatically you get this kind of teaching of somebody. Where from you get? We are very, you know, anxious about this point. Then Prahlad Maharaj giving answer very fearful, very carefully. Paraha sascheti sadgraho pungsam janamayaya kritaha. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, it is done by somebody. This kind of teaching done by whom? You yourself develop that kind of teaching. This is actually maya, 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 maya. Everybody in maya. Prahladma speaking, paraho sasche vajan paraho sascheti asadgraho pungsam jan maya yakritam. This maya, mahamaya, by the influence of maya, maya, mahamaya, everybody thinking this way. This is mine, it is yours. This is our, this is yours. Paraha sascheti asad graho pungsam yad mayaya kritaha. Bimohi tadhyam drishtas tasmai bhagavate namaha. I want to pray Dandavati, that Supreme Lord. Because by the influence of the maya of that Supreme Lord, people thinking this way. It is mine, it is yours. How you develop yourself from outside? This by maya. So this way, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, after that actually, Prahlad Maharaj now speaking, je nobody can give actually this kind of insight. It's not possible. Those who are in maya, because everybody in maya, so those who are in maya, how they can advise me about Krishna bhajan? But Prahlad Maharaj not speaking the secrecy that I developed this kind of, you know, education from my Gurudev, Naradji. Not speaking. This way actually, Prahlad Maharaj now, actually, Naradji speaking now, the two teachers, they like to treat him right way. They like to give some treatment to Prahlad Maharaj so that Prahlad Maharaj can speak rightly. If confess, okay. If don't confess, we can get one, you know, stick to beat. Sham, Dan, Bhed, Dando. Four kind of procedure there to get you in control of me. Where is that procedure? Sham mean first again, very sweetly. But so, my son, how you get this way? If you are successful, okay. Sam Dan, I can give you donation, big prize. If you speak. Bhed, hey, be careful. Can beat you. Don't mean a final punishment. Four kind of procedure to get you in control of me. But Guru Vaishnav never follow these four, any of these four procedure. Never, 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 never follow. So, Naradji speaking, Anyotam are betram asmakam
Ajaskaraha. Prahlad, it is defamation. They actually, Prahlad Maharaj, we are getting, you know, bad name for Prahlad. Hey, get stick. We like to beat. Anyatamare betram asmakam ajaskaraha. Kulanga raso durvadher stotutthyo chaturtho asso udito dama. Actually, fourth, the samdam bheddanda, the fourth, even fourth kind of treatment is good for him. We can beat him. Anyata mare betram asmakam ajaskaraha. Kulanga rasyo durvadher chaturtho asso dito dama. We can proceed with a fourth, you know, procedure. We can beat him. Speak right way, where from you get. This way actually, Prahlad Maharaj, now he is always, Prahlad Smarani. Vishnu Sravane Parikshit Abhavat, Vyasaki Kirtane, Prahlad Smarani. So now Prahlad Maharaj is Mahajan, he keeps silence. He cannot speak because they are fighting with them. I like to beat him, treat him very wrong way, by rubbish way, rude way. Actually they are speaking that actually where from you get this kind of. So now they are trying to give nice lesson to Prahlad Maharaj so that any more mistake cannot happen anymore. There cannot be any mistake. So they are very carefully again giving lesson to Prahlad Maharaj repeatedly so that no problem can happen. Again they are taking Prahlad Maharaj in front of King Hiranyakashipu. Then Hiranyakashipu again taking Prahlad Maharaj in lap. And what happens? It is written there. Aropyankam abhagrayo murdhani yasrukalambhi asinchan vikasad bhaktam idamahu yudhisthira. Hey Yudhisthira! Because in between, so many harikatha going. You cannot understand. Actually, mainly, Parikshit Maharaj hearing Sukhdev Goswami speaking. After that, again, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, or Sanakadi Rishi hearing. After the in between, so many speakers. So you can get confused. Be careful. Those who are hearing Bhagavad, they should be very careful. Here, actually, Naraji Maharaj speaking in front of Yudhisthira Maharaj, this topic. So, Saptam Skanda when started, actually, in front of Yudhisthira Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj speaking. So, this way. Ankam Arap, Bachan Arapya Ankam Abhagrayo. Putting a son on lap and getting the smell on his head. Very affectionately. Arapya Ankam Abhagrayo Murdhani Astrukalambhi. Astrukalambhi is tears rolling down the cheeks of Hiranyakashipu and falling on the head of Prahlad Maharaj, is written. Arapya Ankyam Abhagrayo Murdhani Astru Kalambhi. Astru Kalambhi, tears rolling down continuously and falling on Prahlad Maharaj. Because Prahlad Maharaj is sitting here on lap. And this way, Hiranyakashipu loved Prahlad Maharaj so much. Up to what point? So, asinchat vikasat bhaktam idam aho Yudhisthira. Hey Yudhisthira, now with this loveful attitude, loveful mood, he is kissing his son and asking. Hiranyakashipu now asking. Prahlad, my son, Prahlad anuchyatam tato swadhitam kinchiduttamam.
what kind of lesson you got from your Gurukul? Can you, could you speak something? Not any specific question, because Prahlad Maharaj can feel nervous, he is big king. So, this is a very, very, you know, they are also, you know, Asur, they are also sometimes showing mercy, but that mercy is useless mercy. You see, Prahlad, Prahlad anuchyatam tato swadhitam kinchiduttamam kale naitab batayusman jad asikshat gurur bhavan. Gurur bhavan, guru theke, from guru, what you learned, could you speak something, what you got from there? I like to hear. Prahlad now speaking that topmost answer. Savanam kirtanam visnosmaranam padasevanam archanam bandhanam dasyam shaksham atmanivedanam iti pungsar pita vishnu bhaktis chetnavalakshana kriyeta bhagavati adhya tanmanni aditamottamam. Hey, Suravarjo, I think it fit. What kind of teaching you got? Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Badanam, Dasyam, Saksham, Atma, Nivedanam. Iti, Pungsar, Pito. Pungsa, Pungsa, Mane? By human being, by human being. I mean, those human beings, if they are showing bhakti this way unto the lotus feet of Vishnu. Iti pungsa or pungsa, bahuvachan, plural number, not pungso. Iti pungsa arpita Vishnu. Potanta lo shasti vibhakti, sixth case ending in Vyakaran Sanskrit, and Vishnu is seventh case ending, saptami vibhakti. Iti pungsar pita Vishnu bhaktis chet. Chet mean suppose. By chance, those human being they are showing bhakti unto the lotus feet of Vishnu, then kriyeto, if it is done. Chet. Chet mean if at all they are doing. Chet. Kriyeto bhagavati adhya. Tanmanne aditamuttam. That I think the best education in this whole infinite universe. He is speaking this way? Again he is speaking about bhakti? And ninefold of bhakti. Savanam kirtanam Vishnu smaranam pada sevanam archanam madnanam dasyam saksham atma nivedanam iti pungsar pita bhakti bhakti Vishnu bhakti schet navalakshana kriyeta bhagavati adhya tanmanne aditamottamam. Now, Prahlad Maharaj speaking about Navavidava, ninefold of bhakti. Ninefold of bhakti. Then Hiranyakashipu becomes very angry, fire. Nishamma maitat suto vacho Hiranyakashipu tada guru putram uvachedam rusha spuritadhara. Hey! Where from he is getting that kind of education? Nishamma maitat. Bacho, suto bacho. Suto bacho means, suto means song. Hearing all this kind of, you know, bhakti from Prahlad, suto, and Viharanyakashipu become very angry. Guru putram uvache idam. Uvacho idam. Guru putro, guru putram. Guru putram means to guru putro. He is speaking. Hiranyakashipu. Rusha, very angry. Spuritadhara. Brahma bandhu kim etatte vipakshaha vipaksham srayatasata srayatasata. Balche Brahma bandhu kim etatte vipakshaha vipaksham srayatasata. Printing mistake here. Actually it is ditya, second case ending. Brahma bandhu, you are not actually Brahman. Because those who are Brahman, pure, but they should speak. They have no politics in their heart. No, you know. You are actually speaking lie. Where from you? Brahma bandhu kim etatte vipaksham srayata srata. Srayata asata. Asaram grahito balo
mam anadrita durmate. You violate my instruction.
Last time also I told you to teach my son properly. You are again giving lesson improper way. Why? You are violating my instruction.
Asaram grahito balo.
Asar mean useless thing. You are teaching to my son. Where? Then, you know, Guru Putta Dvaya, those teacher, two teachers, Guru Dvayam, become very frightened. Huh? Guru Dvaya, those Guru, two teachers are speaking. Hey Rajan, don't become angry with us. Please believe me. Believe us. We never teach him that way.
Na mat pranitam na paro pranitam suto vadatiye satavendro satro naisargikam matirasya rajan nijachamannam kadadasmo mana.
Don't become angry with us. Actually, your son automatically speaking this way. How possible? Really, believe us.
Na mat pranitam na paro pranitam. We never teach him this way.
And also, there is no scope. There is no scope that outside people can come, enter into our school and giving lesson that way. But we automatically find that this kind of lesson is growing from heart. Really, believe us.
No mat pranitam, no paro pranitam, suto badati esha, tavendro shatro, Naisargikiyam matirasarajan nijachamanyum kadadas momano.
Don't become very angry with us. We never. Narad vacho. Then Narad speaking.
Guru naivam prati prakta bhuyo aha asura sutam. Nochet guru mukhyam te kuto abhadra sati matihi.
Narad vacho, guru naivam prati praktya. When two teachers speaking this way, then Hiranyakashipu speaking,
guru naivam prati prakto bhuyo aha sura sutam no ched guru mukhiyam te kuto abhadra sati mati.
If you are not learning this from guru, then where from you are learning? Getting this kind of education?
Kuto abhadra sati mati.
Where from you are getting this kind of bad mentality, rubbish mentality of Krishna Bhakti? Then Prahlad Maharaj is very humble mood speaking. Prahlad Maharaj is never agitated. Those who are doing bhakti, they are never agitated. They become very humble mood.
Motir na kishne parato satoba mitho vipade to giho vratanam adant govir vishatam tamistram punaha puno charvito charvananam.
Prahlad Maharaj now giving answer.
Motir na kishne parato satoba mitho vipade to giho vratanam.
It is not possible that somebody can get Krishna Bhakti. Motirna Krishna Parato Satova. Mito Vipaddeto Grihabratanam. Those who are Grihabrata, their mind and heart always absorbed in material sansar. It is not possible for them to get in touch with Vishnu. Motirna Krishna Parato Satova.
Motirna kishne parato satoba,
not directly or indirectly, they cannot get motirna kishne parato satoba, mitho vipadde de giha patana.
Adanta govir vishatam tamisram, they have no control over their sense organ. Those are grihastha, those who are not actually proper grihastha. Grihastha is very good, but those who are not proper grihastha, they have no control over their sense organ.
Adanta govir vishatam tamisram. Punaha charvita charvanana.
Those who are grihastha, they are getting same kind of enjoyment, but
but still they are not feeling dissatisfaction. Same enjoyment in family life they are getting, same thing, same thing, same thing, but still they are not growing detachment. How possible? Adanta Govir Vishadanta Mishram. As they are falling down and down and down in tama. Gradually they are falling down in tama, tama, tama. And punaha, punaha, charvita, charvana. Same thing they are enjoying. But still they are not feeling dissatisfaction. They are not feeling detachment. Same thing. But not. After that, Prahlad Maharaj giving. How that those two guru, how they can advise me about Krishna Bhakti? They themselves don't know how they can give me. They don't know about Krishna Bhakti. How they can give me? Na te vidu sartha gothehi Vishnu. Dura sayaje vahirarthaman. Andhāyathandayirupamīyamāna steyo pisichatānta murudām nibādhyā nāte vidu svārtha gatim hi Vishnum durāsayāje vahirārthamānyā andhāyathandayirupamīyamāna steyo pisichatānta murudām nibādhyā. How they can advise me about Krishna Bhakti? They themselves don't know. Nāte vidu svārtha gatim hi Vishnum. Finally, all Jivatma, they should reach Vishnu. No other way. Not a vidu sartha gati me Vishnu. So many big way I can explain, but time is very limited. So big way I can explain. But actually, not a vidu sartha gati me Vishnu. The actually personal interest mean, actually, personal interest mean, if I like to personify you, I like to speak about your Jivatma. The Jivatma, for Jivatma, Krishna Bhakti is the only interest. For Jivatma, the only interest there inside your heart is Krishna Bhakti. But you don't like to confess it because you are in Maya. So actually, Nate Vidu Swartha Gati Me Vishnu, those bonded souls, they cannot feel. Ultimately, we will have to reach Vishnu Charan. We will have to do Vishnu Bhakti. No other way open in front of us. Maybe this life or next life or thousands of, but after we can. Anyway, we will have to come. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnu dura sayaje vahir arthaman. Those guru, those guru dvayam, how they can Guru Dvaya, how they can understand? Because they themselves don't know. They themselves don't know that Vishnu is the ultimate goal for all Jivatma. They don't know. And their Bahirarthaman means their heart always running outside for material enjoyment. Their heart is always running outside to find material enjoyment. Bahirarthaman. And if one blind going to guide another blind, what is the result? If one blind going to guide another blind, what is the ultimate result? They can all two fall down. If one blind going to guide another blind, what is the ultimate result? What you can get? They can both fall down. Andhaya sandhi rupagiyamanam. Andha, if blind teacher, blind guru is guiding you, you are also going to fall down in Maya. Follow? Also you are going to fall down because your Gurudev is in Maya, you are also in Maya. No way. So, andha yathandi rupagiyamanam teya visishtanta urudham nivadhyā. They are bonded like, you know, ox, you know, bull. Yeah, they have chain in nose, rope. They make nozzle and pull. This way. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnum. Vishnum durasayaji bahirarthaman.
andhaya sandhi rupuvyamanam stiyapi sichatanta murudam nevatya. After that, Prahlad Maharaj giving nice advice, it is for all, it is a very good advice. Naishang mati stavaduru kramanghim sprishatyanarthapagamo yadartho mohi asampadar jo vishekam niskinchananam no binito yavad. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Naishang mati stavaduru kramanghim sprishati. Na eshang manaha. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Naishang mati stavad urukraman. That means, na eshang manaha stavad urukramangin speshati anartha apagamaha yadartha. How they can develop this kind of nice brain? How their brain can touch, her heart can touch Supreme Lord? They are not lucky. Because naishang mati stavad urukra, na eshang manaha. Naishang mati, stavad urukramang sprishyati. Your heart cannot touch the lotus feet of Supreme Lord until and unless you are getting full kripa from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Until and unless you are not getting kripa from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, I mean the dust powder from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, till then your brain cannot touch Supreme Lord. Follow, you see? Naishang, naishang mati stavad urukramangi svishati. Anarthagamam, anarthapagamam yadattho. You cannot erase, you cannot go out of anartha. Until and unless you are getting dust particle, the lotus from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. You cannot go out of maya. Naishang mati stavad urukramangi svishati. Anarthapagamam yadattho. Anartho, if anartho is there, anartho you know? Anartho means all bad things there. They are inside your heart. Till then you cannot do proper Krishna bhakti. Naishang mati stavad urukramangi svishati. Anarthapagamam yadattho. Mahiya samrajo padavabhiseka niskinchana anang namnito yavad. Until and unless you are taking bath. Bath. Unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. I mean from the dust particle and from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, you cannot get that kind of fine idea. You cannot start Hari Bhajan. So this way actually Hiranyakashipu will become very angry. Hiranyakashipu was speaking very angry. The Hiranyakashipu giving instruction to all, you know, all demons. Hey! Kill him! Right now. Kill him! Go taking away from me. Then after that, Hiranyakashipu throw the son. Prahlad Maharaj was sitting in lap. Take Prahlad and throw. Hey, kill him! Right now. All Asura, they are running to kill Prahlad. But they cannot kill Prahlad. Weapon, all weapon useless. They are using weapon to kill Prahlad, but useless. They cannot kill. Weapon, not, you know, they cannot kill Prahlad. After that, they putting Prahlad Maharaj inside cave. They are throwing Prahlad Maharaj from hilltop down on inside sea. This way, giving poison to Prahlad Maharaj. They are allowing mad elephant to go over Prahlad Maharaj. They are not successful. Every time Hiranyakashipu is a failure, then Hiranyakashipu is fed up. Hiranyakashipu cannot take decision anymore right now. What to do? He becomes very afraid. Huh? I am trying so much, but I cannot kill that small boy. What is the problem? Huh? Maybe some problem is there. So Hiranyakashipu becomes very frightened, you see.
After that, Hiranyakasipu actually, you know, wanted to get answer by what to do. After that again, actually, those teacher, they are taking him away. After that, Prahlad Maharaj, you know, giving instruction to whom? Those Prahlad Vacha. In school, there are so many boys here. In school, there are so many boys. So Prahlad Maharaj, when those two teachers going outside for some seva, then all, you know, boys, small boys, they are coming to Prahlad Maharaj to get exact teachings from Prahlad Maharaj. So they are sitting all around Prahlad Maharaj giving instruction, Prahlad Maharaj giving instruction. All small boys, they are coming and sitting all around Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj giving instruction. Prahlad Maharaj in front of the small boys, their brain is not contaminated, not yet contaminated. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Oh my brothers, oh my friends, Komara Achayat Pragyo Dharmana Bhagavataniho Durlabham Manusam Janmo Tadapi Adhrubam Arthadam. Prahlad Maharaj giving instruction. Prahlad Maharaj giving instruction to those, you know, those small boys, I mean friends. Oh my friends. Giving instruction, so nice instruction. Actually, oh my friends, actually, you should start bhajan, Kaumaracharya, when you are adolescent age, you should start bhajan. 5 years of age is more than sufficient. You should start your bhajan right now. Kaumaracharya Pragya Dharmana Bhagavataniho. Bhagavad Dharma, you can start from adolescent age. Durlabham Manusam Janmo. This human birth is rare, you see. Durlabham Manusam Janmo Tadapi Adhrubam Arthadam. Though human life is unstable, but still it has got a nice meaning. What meaning? What meaning? That through Hari Bhajan you can go back to Krishna. It is meaningful. Adhrubam. Yadvi Adhrubam means unstable. Still, it is very useful because you are going to get bhakti. You can reach up to Sri Krishna, lotus feet of Krishna, if you are doing bhakti. Sukham Indrakam Datya, Sukham Indrakam Datya Deho Jogena Dehinam Sarvatra Labhate Daivad Yatha Dukham Ajatnata. You are never trying to get misery. You are trying to get misery? You expect complaint? Actually, only Kunti Devi. Kunti Devi only Kunti Devi asking. Hey Krishna, we want a different kind of problem from you. Problem? Yes. We want to get different kind of problem in our life. Why? Because if we are put it into problem, then we can call you, we can think about you. So this way we can have the chance to get in constant, to get constant touch of your lotus feet. So actually, sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam sarvatra labhate daiva jatha dukyam ajatnata. You are never trying to get misery. You are trying? Get problem? Never. You always try to get some benefit, happiness. But you don't know the actual definition of happiness. You know the actual definition of happiness? If you know, then why you are expecting to become happy? You actually don't know. Actual happiness. Sukham indriyakam daitya deha yogena dehiram sarvatra labhate. You are going to get this kind of material enjoyment, sukha, from everywhere in this material world. Sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam sarvatra labhate. Everywhere, everybody getting. Because according to previous luck, they are getting this kind of enjoyment. So there is not a big problem. Sukama India kam dhatya deho yogina dehinam sarvatulabhate daivad yatha dukcham ajatnataha. Nobody wants to get misery, but still misery coming in their life. Tat prayasana kartabbo yato ayurvayo param na tatha bindati kshema mukunda charanam bhuja. Tat prayasana kartabbo, it is not good for you. It is not good for you to run for material enjoyment. Tat prayasana kartabbo. This kind of effort is not. You should not run behind material enjoyment. Tat prayasana kartabbo yato ayurvayo param. You are going to lose your life. Ayurvayo param na tatha bindati khema mukunda charanam bhajam. Without the devotion of mukunda charan, never you can get full satisfaction. Saturation cannot come. Tato yate to kusala khemayo bhavam asritaha sariram purusham javad na vipadde to puskalam. Your body is there, material body. Till then, your body going to collapse. Your body going to get collapsed today or tomorrow. Be careful. So you will have to engage your body, mind and sense, everything for Krishna bhajan. Tato yateto kusala. So you have to try and try again. Tato yateto kusala khemayo bhavamasritaha sariram purusham javat na vipaddeta puskalam. Until and unless you are going to, your body going to collapse, you have to try again and again. So this way Prahlad Maharaj is giving so many advice. Actually, I have no time to discuss in detail. Someday I can discuss. But I can speak two or three slokas, I cannot explain actually. Prahlad Maharaj is giving advice. Katham priyaya anukam pitaya sangyam rahasyam ruchirangscha mantran suhit sutat sneho hasito sisunam kalaksharanam anurakta chitto. This way actually is giving advice, so nice. After that, finally giving advice, nahi achyutam pranayato bahubhava yaso suratmaja. Ho surwais, it is not a big problem for you because Krishna is sitting inside your heart. You need not run and here and there, you need not search. Hey, nahi achyutam pranayato, to satisfy achyuto, to satisfy Achyuto, Vishnu, Krishna, is not a big problem. Because Krishna is sitting inside your heart, Achyuto. Nahi Achyutam Pranayato Bhavayaso Suratmaja Atmatat Sarvabhutanam Siddhitat Iyo Sarvata. Because where it knows, where you can show me one place where Krishna is not there? Can you show me one place when Krishna is not there? Everywhere Krishna. Krishna is omnipresent. So, nahi achyutam pranayato bahubayaso suratmaja atmatat sarvabhutanam siddhitat iham sarvataha. Atma is present everywhere. Atma vasamidam sarvam jatkinchit jagadam ya. Atma is everywhere. You cannot see Atma. You can see? Everywhere Atma is there. I cannot see. So now point is, atmottat sarvabhutanam siddhitat iya sarvata. Everywhere Krishna is there. So you need not search Krishna. You need not search Supreme Lord. Only we'll have to concentrate. You can search Vadivajan. That's why I would advise you, Prahladma speaking in front of Asura Vyas, Tasmat. That's why I would advise you, Tasmat sarveshu bhuteshu dayam kurutu sauhidam. Don't try to hate anybody. You try to develop amicable, loveful relation with everyone. Oh, Jivatma, it is written. Tasmat sarveshu bhuteshu
Dayam kuruto sohidam. You will have to show daya, mercy to everybody. Ajivatma. Bhavam asuram unmacho. Jaya tusati adokhajam. You can leave asura bhava. Because you are asura wise. Asura bhava is there. You must eliminate. Drive away. Then Achyuta Krishna became very happy. Tushte cha tatra kimalabhyam ananta ade king toir guna vetikaradiho jesa siddhya dharmadayo kimagunena cha kankitena swaram jusam charanayo rupugayo tamana tushte cha tatra kimalabhyam ananta ade king toir guna vetikaradiho jesa siddhya dharmadayo kimagunena cha kankitena swaram jusam charanaya rupugayo tamna tushte cha tatta kimalabhyam ananta ade. Wait, when Supreme Lord is satisfied, what you cannot get? Everything you can get. Tushte cha tatra kimalabhyam ananta ade king toir guna vyatikaradi ho jesa siddhya dharmadayo kimagunena cha kankitena swaram jusam chara charanayo rupugayo tamna. He was so gone. Oh my friends, ananta rupi hari, if satisfied, you can get everything what you want. No kind of dissatisfaction can stay inside your heart. But you have to try. Nibandhan daiva vase bina jatne ya siddha hai sei sato siddha dharmadi janno chesta korai ki fol. If you are trying for material thing, if you are trying for to get material thing or material enjoyment, what kind of benefit you can get? Is good? Not good actually. This way Prahlad Maharaj speaking all about Krishna bhajan. And now boys, they are asking, Prahlad, one question we have. How you develop this kind of bhakti? Because you and all of us together reading here in the school of Sandhya and Amarka, but how you develop that kind of teaching, whereas we not? Then Prahlad Maharaj speaking all history, all I speak before. When Mandarachalan, my father going to Mandarachalan, then I already told Kayadhu, my mother, she was caught by Indra, and on I have told everything. Actually, this way, Narada Vacha, they actually Guru Sushaya Bhaktya Sarabo Labharpanena Cha Sangena Sadhu Bhaktya Nam Ishwara Aradhanaina Cha Guru Sushasaya Bhaktya Sarvo Labharpanena Cha Sangena Sadhu Bhaktyanam Ishwara Aradhanaina Cha. You will have to follow Sadguru properly, Guru Sushasaya. You will have to serve your Sadguru and Bhakta out of full devotion. You will have to try. Then and only then you can get this kind of condition. Sraddhaya tatkathyancha kittanair guno karmanam tatpadambu ruho dhyanat tat lingir lingyar khatar hanadivi. Harihi sarveshu bhudeshu bhagavan bhagavanah tat ishwarah iti bhutani manasa kamai stoi sadhu ma manet bhavchen. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj is explaining this way how to do bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj giving advice, you cannot hate anybody, you should develop that kind of love, show, you know, sympathy to other. You can show sympathy to other jiva also. And you will have to serve a pure Vaishnava. You can give everything unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, whatever you receive, aje, sraddhaya tat kathayancha kirtanai gunakarmanam, and before that it is written, guru susaya, guru susaya bhaktya, sarva labhar panena cha. Whatever you get, you will have to offer unto the lotus feet of Gurudev, sangena sadhu bhaktyanam iswar aradhanecha. You will have to stay with Sadguru and Sadvaishnava, and by Ishwar Aradhan you have to worship Krishna this way, then you can get everything and all. This way actually, Prahlad Maharaj and Naradji Maharaj speaking, Naradji Maharaj speaking, Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Guru and front of all Asura Vyas. This way, after that, someday again Prahlad Maharaj coming in front of Gurudev. Then Prahlad Maharaj asking, Hiranyakashipu asking, then Hiranyakashipu again speaking same thing. Then Hiranyakashipu speaking, you are speaking that your Hari Vishnu is everywhere. Can you show that your Hari is there inside this pillar? You can show? Can you show? Then Prahlad Maharaj speaking, yes, I can show. Then show. Otherwise, I can kill you. You are speaking very big way. Can you show that Krishna is there inside this pillar? Can you show? Prahlad Maharaj says, yes, I can show. Satyam vidhatam nijavitta bhasitam vyaptincha bhuteshu akhileshu shatmanaha adrishyatvatat bhuta rupam udbhuhano stambe sabayam na megam na manusham. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, yes, you can also get my Supreme Lord here in this pillar. Then Hiranyakashipu provide one feast. Then satyam vidatam nijavittavasam, my servant, actually my devotee, speaking this way. So Prahlad Maharaj wanted to prove this point and manifest from inside this pillar. Hiranyakashipu manifest. How looking? It is in Nayang Migo Napi Naro Vichitramaho Kimetat Nirmeganda Rupam. Not like lion, not like man, half lion, half man. Nayang Migo Napi Naro Vichitramaho Kimetat Nirmeganda Rupam. Half Miganda, half lion, half man. Mimamsa manasya samutthito agrate nishinga rupa stadalam bhayanakam. This way, actually, when they are thinking, what is this? Hiranyakashipu thinking, what is this? Half man, half lion? This kind of, you know, nayang migo napi naro vichitra maho kim etad nibhiganda rupam. Mimamsa manasya samasthito agre nishinga rupam taralam tadalam bhayanakam. Hiranyakashipu is, you know, thinking this way. In the meantime, in front of Hiranyakashipu, nishinga rup appear. It is very, very dangerous. Nobody can fear. So, like thousands of sun at a time appearing so far. So tej. After that, actually, pratapta chami karachanda lochanam spurat sata vesharo jimbhitananam karala dangstram karavalo chanchalo khuranta jivham brukuti mukholvanam. This way, actually, pratapta chami karachanda lochanam. Eyes is like sun, glowing, fire. This way actually everybody become frightened. And actually in front of Hiranyakashipu, now Nrisimhadeva appear. After that fighting going on, Hiranyakashipu is challenging mood, fighting with Nrisimhadeva. He is also fighting.
this way, after that, they are fighting in between. After Hiranyakashipu and Prahlad and Nrisimhadev putting Hiranyakashipu on left and pierce the heart of Nrisimhadev. This way, actually, Prahlad Maharaj, you know, in front of Prahlad Maharaj is coming. Now, point is there, we like to explain so many things, but time is very limited. So I cannot explain in details so many seva, I will have to go. I can speak some sloka by Prahlad Maharaj, some advice actually of Prahlad Maharaj. You can go on hearing about this. One or two I can explain, not all. Say Prahlad Maharaj vacho, Brahmadayo surogana munayato siddhya sattaikatanagatayo vachasam pravahoi. Naraditum purogonai roduna pipi pro king tostum miharati somi hari rugrajati manne dana vijanarupo tapasuto yahati yaha prabhava balapuru sabuddhi yoga naradana yahi vavanti parasapunso bhaktatutoso bhagavan gajujutupayo vipradisaraguna jutad arabindanavo Padar vinda vimukha sapajam barishtam manneta darpita manu bachaniya hitartha panam punati sat sakulam not hurimana vipradisaraguna jutad urabinda nabo padar vinda vimukha sapajam barishtam manneta darpita manu bachaniya hitartha panam punati sat Kulam natu bhuri mana naivat mano prabhurayam nijalavatu purno manam janada vidiso karuno brinite naivat mano prabhurayam nijalav purno manam janada vidiso karuno brinite jad jad jano bhagavata vidadhita manam tachatmane patimukasajata jatapukasri Tasmat aham bigata viplava viplava isvarasya sarvatmanamohi grinami yathavat jathamanisham. Bhajan tasmat aham bigata viplava isvarasya sarvatmanamohi grinami yathanam jathamanisham. Nicho ajaya guna visargamanu pravisto puyeto jena hi praman anuvarnitena sarve hi omi vidhi karastavo satya satta dhamno brahmadayo bayam mivesho no chodhijanto khemayo bhutayo bhutatma sukhayo chasyo vikritam bhagavato ruchirat ruchi ruchiravatarai This way, different kind of stotra by Prahlad Maharaj. Naham bibhemite otibhayanakasyo jivharko netra bhukati ravaso gradangstat antasrajaha khataja kesaro sankukarnat nirhad abhito digvadari vinnanakhagrat trasto osmi aham kipanavasara dusaha agro ugro samsara chakra kadanadga sutam panito badhya sakaramo rushottamo te angrimulam mishpito apavarga saranam ahvayase kadanu Yasmad priya priya vyoga sangyog janamo sokagni nasakal janamis sakal janisu da jamana dikho shadam tadvidukshyam atadiyo ham bhuman 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 bhumami badami tabadasa yogam Yasmad priya priya vyoga sangyog janamo Shukagni nasakala janisu dajjamanu dukkau sadam tadapi duksham atadhyya aham bhamonabhamami badami tavadasa yogam swaham piyasa sruhida paradevatai paradevataya lilakatastavo nishingo virinchigita anjahas titarmi anugrin ginnano guno vipramukto durganite pada jugalo jugalayo hamso sanga.
This way actually Prahlad Maharaj going on doing stava.
Naham rajo prabhavo isho tamo dike osmin jataho suretara kule katavanu kampa na brahm na brahmano na tu bhavasya na vairamaya janme arpito sirasi padmakaraha prasada.
This way Prahlad Maharaj going on doing stotra, big stotra.
Jivai kato achyuto vikarsati mavitipta sishno annatahastak udaram sravanam kutaschit ghrano annatahaschapaladrikka chakarma sakti bahavo sapatna iva gihapatin lulanti evam sakarma patitam bhavavaitaranya manna anna janma maranasana vita vitam Pasana janam sappara vigraha vaira maitram kanteti parachara piprihimura madhya paena deva munayo sabimukti kama maunam charanti vijanena patha nishtana itano vihayo kipano vimumuksha viko nanyanta dasasaranam bhamata nupashe.
This way Prahlad Maharaj big stop, this is, and Prahlad Maharaj doing stop in front of Hiranyakashipu. Why? Because those demigods, they are very fearful, they cannot approach Nrisimhadev. They are requesting Prahlad, even Brahma, oh my son, you go approach your Prabhu. Because for you, Prabhu coming here in this material world. So you must go and satisfy your Supreme Lord. After that, Hiranyakashipu approaching, doing stotra. Hiranyakashipu, Nrisimha Bhagavan become very happy because now Asuragan. After that, Hiranyakashipu gone previously. After that, this stotra going. Then Prahlad Maharaj, in front of Prahlad Maharaj, Nrisimha speaking, you must ask something from me, some benediction. But Prahlad Maharaj speaking, I don't need any benediction because you come in front of me. This is my benediction. Māmāṁ pralobhayat patyāsaktam kāmeshu tvair varair yat saṅga bhīto nirvinyo mamukṣustam upāsrita.
I want to get your lotus feet. I want nothing. You don't try to put in a different kind of offer, lucrative offer. Please, Prabhu, don't try to put different kind of lucrative offer in front of me. Otherwise, I can lose my patience and ask, Prabhu, give me this one. Because you are Bharadhar Sabha, you are topmost. Benediction you can give. Māmāṁ pralobhayat patyāsaktam kāmeshu tvair varair tat saṅga bhīto nirvinno mumukṣustvam upāsrita.
I am taking shelter unto your lotus feet. I don't care for any material benefit. Please, Prabhu, don't show me this kind of lucrative offer. Show me. I like to get your seva. Nothing else. This way, actually, Prahlad Maharaj requesting in front of Hiranyakashipu, in front of Nrisimhadev. This way, actually, we get nice advice. So many. If I go on discussing for 6 months, 1 year, very one line, it's top secret, very top secret here. So after that, again, I like to stop this point because so many points I like to discuss. Here, actually, now, in front of Yudhishthir Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj again speaking. Naraji Maharaj speaking, hey Rajan, Yudhishthir, you are actually lucky. You are lucky actually. Why?
Juyam niloke vatabhuri bhaga lokam punana manayo vijanti jesam grihana vasati tisakshat guram parabrahma manu salingam.
You are very lucky because Krishna always staying inside your room, house. Oh, yogi gani, they cannot get Krishna, but Krishna always coming to your house, staying with you. This way,
Actually, I like to stop here. Prayena deva munayo sabhi mukti kama maunam charanti vijanina parartha nishtha naitana vihayo kipunam vimumukshayeko nanyam tadasa saranam brahmato nupasi vanchakalpadarusik basindu bebejavati dhanam bhavane poishnapyo.